Melbourne-based footballer Hakeem al-Araibi
fled Bahrain in 2014 and was later granted asylum in Australia.
Hakeem al-Araibi crying for help to stop his deportation from Thailand to Bahrain.
After stepping off a plane for his honeymoon in Thailand, Hakeem al-Araibi was arrested. Thai authorities detained the political refugee, acting on an invalid Interpol warrant from Bahrain.
Your wife sends her love, Hakeem. All of Australia is with you. Be strong, buddy.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Craig Foster.
Former Socceroos captain and broadcaster Craig Foster spearheaded the movement to...
Save Hakeem!
Told him that the players of the world are fighting hard for him. And I said, I believe we're going to win the battle.
A team of human rights activists, social media warriors and members of the international football community worked tirelessly to expose the injustices inflicted on Hakeem.
This is about taking on the biggest powers in world football.
After spending 77 days behind bars, Hakeem was freed.
I love Australia.
The Defenders uncovers how the Save Hakeem movement took on two monarchies and the world's most powerful sporting body, and how close they came to losing.
If the life of Hakeem is not equally as valuable as the billions of dollars of influence, then the soul of football is dead.
Craig and Hakeem, join us now. Such an incredible documentary. Hakeem, you're in a much better place these days. What does life look like for you now?
To be honest, I'm still worried about myself, about my family back in Bahrain, especially after my my story. It show with many people. And, I'm just worried on... I don't want the Bahrain government to take a revenge from my family. That important things about myself. And I'm still doing what I love to do. Like I'm working with Football Victoria and working with the kids, helping them to play football, helping to be settled in Australia.
At the centre of all this, just for some background for everyone at home, you were accused of burning down a police station in Bahrain during the Arab Spring. But what were you actually doing at the time?
I was playing in the life. I was playing football with Bahraini League.
And live on television?
Yeah. And I believe Bahrain government, they arrested me because I'm from Shia. And they just stopped me on the street and they just put this case against me because they don't want to Shia people to be in high position. No, not just only the sports. There is a doctor, there is engineering, all of them, and especially if they are Shia people, they been in jail.
Craig, what? No. Oh, sorry. Okay. Craig, what made you want to get involved and come aboard and help out?
Well, I wasn't alone. You know, it ended up hundreds of thousands of Australians. And in fact, you know, one of the reasons why the film's been made is to thank Australia for what they did because, you know, so many people stood up for Hakeem, including this show and you know, many of you, and I know Liz, you know, as a sporting legend also was on board at that time. But this show, in fact, came over the first time we went to Bangkok. And when I went in to see Hakeem in prison, actually sent a camera over and so was, you know, right at the forefront of making sure that this story came to the consciousness of Australians, and that was really important.
Do you think it makes a difference? Because I often wonder, like, yeah, do these big media campaigns,
yeah,
does it actually shift the dial in terms of getting the freedom for someone like this?
Well, it shifts a dial, but the question is a little bit more complex, Hamish, around whether it's appropriate in every case.
Yeah.
And the answer to that is it's not. So, you know, there is a kind of movement in Australia, and I know the Australian government have been thinking about this more deeply as well after, yeah, we had, you know, various people, whether it was in Iran or Hakeem and others, and what's been called in recent years hostage diplomacy around when is it appropriate to create a campaign.
Hakeem, you were in prison while this was all unfolding. Did you know what this man was doing and others on your behalf?
I wasn't known. I remember when Craig Foster, he visited me in the prison and he showed me a letter from my wife. And my wife, she said, please, trust of Craig Foster. He's the captain of Socceroos and he's going to help you. And then, I feel confident about about what my wife said about Craig Foster, and I shared all the details with him. And he started showing me what he did behind the scene and what he did. He shared my story with the players, and he showed me what the clubs, how the clubs support me.
Is he your hero?
Of course, he's my hero. He's my family hero as well, my Bahraini people hero as well. Craig, everyone in my country, everyone in my home, is still asking me about Craig, how he's doing. He's like fine. My brother.
Craig, how did you, when you took this on, did you understand the forces that could be amassed against you?
No, I had very little understanding of, you know, the dynamics of, you know, who was involved. And, you know, we talk in the documentary for the first time about the royal families and the monarchies, including in Thailand, and which, you know, we couldn't talk about during the campaign because the laws in Thailand criminalise people who criticise the king, for example. So, you know, we kind of had to evolve as we went along. But, you know, as I've been at pains saying then and in the last 4 years, there was a huge amount of people, great organisations, and many of them, I'm delighted to say, are featured also in the film. And so people can understand, you know, this incredible international coalition of people, including athletes, who stepped forward against this injustice. And I hope, Liz, you know, struck a blow for, you know, the values of sport that we always talk about, but this gives a real insight into the top levels of international sport governance and how much work is required.
It's so great to see you both. You can watch The Defenders on Amazon Prime from tomorrow. It is pretty amazing. Craig Foster, Hakeem al-Araibi, thank you so much.